Okay, welcome back to the channel. This is Shepherd's Pie. My name is Alex. This is Fable. And guess what breed she is? Because I'll give you a clue, she's not a Border Collie. Yeah, she's an Australian Shepherd. I'm not going to leave you with this. She's an Australian Shepherd. I get a lot of people think she's a Border Collie because she's black and white, but look at the little stubby tail. Look at those floppy pants. Not a Border Collie. Anyway, so today, my siblings were actually already going out, and I thought I'd tag along. I'd bring Fable. I want to get some training done. Now, full transparency here, I am not a service dog trainer. Fable is not a service dog, but I want to train her to have the same standards as a service dog. So that's what we're doing today. We're going to work on some service dog stuff. So we're going to bring you along and we're going to have fun with Fable out in town. Now, also before I keep going, as I say, I'm not a service dog trainer, so don't take what I say too much to heart. Take it with a grain of salt. If you know better, if you're a service dog trainer and you know better, ignore what I say because I don't have a clue. I'm just out here to have fun with my little puppy dog and hopefully learn how to be a better dog trainer. Anyway, let's get going.
Just had a little bit of a distraction. Somebody coming up to say hello to her, which she doesn't have her do not pat signs on, so it's understandable, but still, good girl. So this is the kind of engagement you're really looking for. So look how engaged she is with me. She's trying to push me to give her the reward. That's exactly the kind of thing we want, we're looking for. Because a dog who's trying to push me to give the reward is a dog who's going to do everything I ask. Come. Good. Good girl. Amy, stay. Good. Nope. No, Faby. You stay. That's because her auntie Jessie's here.
With coffee.
Yeah, with coffee, and she wants the coffee. Okay, let's get back in the car.
Nervous, aren't you? New place? Haven't been here before.
When we got out of the car, she was very nervous. So you can see, even here, she's looking around, and then somebody on an electric scooter went past, and she thought that was quite scary. Although I do know, with Fable, she has had this wariness of people on wheels for some time now. I just need to work on it a bit more. She's already much better than she was, but she's still a little bit unsure about people on wheels, which I think is cute, but also slightly annoying. Now, the problem is, I'm used to a German Shepherd who, you get her out of the car, and she's like she is at home, basically. Unless there's something really scary happening, she doesn't really care about being in new places. Then again, she's also 3 years old and Fable's only 1 year old and she's not a German Shepherd, so I can't really have the same expectations as I do for Mischa for Fable.
I like using a harness because it encourages confidence because it teaches them to pull into the harness. That's what they're for, by the way. Teaches dogs to pull into the harness, but for confidence building it works very well.
I don't think I explained that very well, because what I was trying to say was that a harness, as opposed to something like a flat collar or any collar with action, is going to increase their confidence more because they get to pull into it and they get more comfort from the harness, and they have nothing to think about. There's nothing inhibiting them at all. The harness, it works really well for dogs that need confidence. On the other hand, if your dog is any bigger than Fable, they might hurt your arm a little pulling into a harness. So that's something to think about. But if you have a timid dog, putting them on a harness should help with their confidence. Also, doing exercises that they normally do at home, outside, where they're nervous, can help. Now, if your dog is so nervous they're not taking treats, then maybe it's not a good idea. Well, it won't work anyway. If they're not taking treats, it won't work. But Fable was taking treats, and doing a little bit of training like this really opened her up again, and she started to feel much more at home, because doing training is something that she's confident doing already, and she's classically conditioned to enjoy it, because I've spent a lot of time having fun with her in training.
Yes, good girl. Eye contact is great, because that means she's relaxed enough that she's willing to start training. And she's willing to take food from me. Yes. Okay, let's keep going. Oh, you're caught. Let's keep going. But let's see how she reacts to going underneath this bridge here. That'll be pretty scary with the noises. Let's see how she goes. She's drooling a little bit too, which is a sign of nervousness. She's pulling me, that's good. Underneath the bridge. Very good, Lammy. Didn't even take any notice. Good girl. Oh, except then. Down. Good. Stand. Good. Speak. Speak. Woof. Speak. Speak. Okay, down. Good. Good girl. You roll over. You might not be in the right mental state for that. Sit. Good. Pretty? Pretty. Good. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl, yeah. You know who your mummy is, don't you?
So you can see she's calmed down quite a lot now, and really she's basically back to her normal self at this point. I let my brother take her for a little run ahead of me, and then I let her run back to me because running can be a great way to help them relax as well. And I was sick. I don't know if I said this earlier in the video, but I was very sick. I was recovering from a sickness in any case, and I was extremely tired. So I couldn't do any running, but I could employ my brother's help to do that. So yeah, you could see she's relaxed so much more. And after that walk, I was really happy with how we ended the session. So we got in the car and we drove to this outdoors shop. I asked the manager if she could come in. He said it was fine. This is where we're at so far with just her basic training indoors. I think she's pretty good. There is one thing I wanted to point out though. You can see that she's whining a lot. No, I wouldn't say stressed. Well, she is stressed, but not in a bad way. It's more that she wants the treat so much that she's stressed about it. This, I will talk about it in a second. But basically, this is not a good thing. I don't want her to be in this state of mind when she's just supposed to be walking along beside me. I'll talk about it in a second. I just wanted to point that out now so you could see.
Good girl. Free. Good girl. Good girl. Good. Close. Good. Good. Sit. Good. Good.
Good. They claim 1,000 feet per second.
Okay.
And they always overclaim the velocity. But
yeah.
That one's okay.
Very light and stable.
Yeah. Big old bulky jacket on.
Yeah. And a lot of the water feels comfortable.
Yeah. I'm not particularly fussed on even the weights. I think feel perfectly comfortable.
Yeah.
So just come out of that side of the shop to give her a little bit of a break, because she's doing really, really well. Like, really, really well. She has to stay in a heel the entire time we're in the shop, and then she also has to, if we're stopped, she has to sit in a down or a settle. See, as you can see, though, she's still anxious. Now, part of her anxiety, I know because I know her, is because she wants to push me to give her more treats. So she's trying to figure out how to actually get the treats, and not being able to work is actually anxiety inducing for her.
So what I was saying in this section, and basically looking back at it, I agree with myself. The reason she has such anxiety, I think, is that the expectation for rewards is really high, because I've previously given her heaps of rewards in this sort of situation, and really frequent rewards too. So she's expecting to get lots of frequent rewards, and that means that because the payoff is so great, her desire to get it right is super, super high. So You would think that giving more rewards is always better. It's not true. Sometimes when you give too many rewards, the dog is trying too hard and that creates too much stress. So in this case, I started using a lot more leash pressure and a lot less rewards. She still got rewarded, but only after a longer period of time. And the reward was of less value to her too. And you can see the results, so she's much more relaxed now.
Yes, good girl. That's a pretty big distraction for little Fable. There's children running past trying to get her attention. Yes, good girl. Those are some very, very big distractions. Close. Very good girl. Good. Settle. Good. Close. Big rewards. Good girl. Good girl. So that was a huge distraction. Those were some pretty huge distractions for her. And she did super well. She was trying so hard, so I've got to giving her a jackpot at the end there just to reward her for that.
After we'd finished at the outdoor shop and the hardware shop, it was time to head home, but I was so happy with how Fable went. She started out super, super nervous, but she got over that and she became confident again. And then we actually got some really good training done indoors with lots of people and lots of distractions, like little children and people trying to pat her. And yeah, we had a really good time and I hope you learned something. I definitely learned something about Fable and about training itself. And if you enjoyed it, leave a like. Tell me the sort of stuff you'd like to see from this channel, what you'd like to learn about dog training, because you know you can always get me to talk about dog training. It's my passion. So yeah, so I'll see you next time.